morning students. In this session, I will solve some important exercise problems. See the first question. How many four-digit numbers can be formed with the numbers 0, 2, 3, 5, 7 such that no digits are repeated? Given question is four-digit number. So here I will take four vacant places. See, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, this represents the four-digit number. Okay, then you need to form the four-digit numbers using the numbers 0, 2, 3, 5, 7. Here observe 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 numbers are given. 5 numbers includes a 0 also. But see, for thousands place, 0 is not possible, because if you take 0 in the thousands place, then your number will become a 3-digit number. So thousands place, out of 5, we can use only 4 numbers. Okay. Then see, other than 0, here one number is fixed. So hundreds place, you can use remaining 4 numbers. Because see, total 5 number are there, then 5 minus 1, 4 numbers are remaining. Okay. Here actually, if 0 is not given, here 5 possibilities, but since 0 is given, here only 4 possibilities. After using one number other than 0, 4 numbers are remaining. So hundreds place can be filled in 4 ways. Then comes tens place, you can fill it in remaining 3 numbers, and units place, you can fill it by remaining 2 numbers. So therefore, total number of 4-digit numbers is equal to 4 into 4 into 3 into 2. Its value is equal to 96. This is the solution for the given question. See the second question. How many 3-digit numbers can be formed that numbers are ending with 7? Okay. Using the number 12578, digits cannot be repeated. Here see, question is a 3-digit number. So here I will take 3 vacant places that represents the 3-digit number. 3-digit number, here units place. Now see, number must ending with 7. That means unit place, only one possibility is there. That means 7 only, right? You need to fix 7. Whatever number you are constructing, in that number unit place must be 7. So here only one possibility is available. Then see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 numbers are given. Out of 5, 1 number is used in unit place. So 4 numbers are available. So tens place can be filled in 4 ways, and hundreds place can be filled in 3 ways. So total numbers is equal to 3 into 4 into 1. It's equal to 12. Okay, there are 12 3-digit numbers are there, which are ending with 7 if you use the numbers 12578. See the next question. In how many ways can the letters of the word hopper be arranged? Okay. Here see, I will write the given word H-O-P-P-E-R. Observe how many letters are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 letters are there, right? N is equal to 6. But our observation is, here all letters are not distinct. Because see, here you can see, na, P repeats 2 times. That you need to write P is equal to 2. Okay. Then there is no repetition, right? Only P repeats 2 times. Okay. So what is our formula? Total number of ways is equal to N factorial divided by P factorial. If any letter repeats, then you need to divide it by that much factor you need to write. Okay. That's a formula for repetition letter, right? So it's equal to N factorial. N value is equal to 6 factorial divided by P value is equal to 2. So 6 factorial divided by 2 factorial. Okay. This is the answer for the given question. Okay. If possible, simplify this one and write the final answer. Okay. See the next question. How many 6-digit numbers can be formed from the digits 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, which are divisible by 5? Okay. First, to see given number is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You need to construct a 6-digit number. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Then see number is divisible by 5. What's the condition? Any number divisible by 5 implies unit place of that number is equal to 5 or 0, right? We observed that in the last problems, any number which is divisible by 5 means, if you observe the unit place of that number, then that unit place either equal to 0 or equal to 5. But here 0 is not given, right? So here only one possibility, unit place is only one possibility, that is 5. Then fill the remaining places. The next place can be filled with, since 6 numbers are given, next place can be filled with 5 ways, here 4 ways, here 3 ways, here 2 ways, and here 1 ways. Clear? Because you need to construct a 6-digit number which is divisible by 5. So, condition is any number is divisible by 5 means their unit place must be either equal to 0 or equal to 5. But here in the given 6 number, 0 is not there. So, unit place only one possibility, that is 5. Then see, out of 6, one number is fixed in unit place. What are the remaining numbers? 6 minus 1 is equal to 5. Now, you need to make the arrangement for the remaining 5 vacant places using 5 remaining numbers. So, see, first can be filled in 5 ways, then 4, then 3, then 2, then 1, because no digit being repeated. So, total arrangements is equal to 1 into 2 into 3 into 4 into 5. This is nothing but 5 factorial ways. Okay. So, total how many 6-digit numbers are there? That is equal to 5 factorial. Then calculate the 5 factorial value. Okay. See the next question. In how many ways can 7 students and 4 teachers be seated in a row such that no two teachers are together? Okay. You need to make arrangement for 7 students and 4 teachers such that no two teachers are together. So, here I will take number of teachers is equal to 4 and number of students is equal to 7. Okay. Now see, no two teachers are together means you need to place teachers between the students, right? So here see, 1 student, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 students are there. Okay. So 7 students can be arranged in how many ways? 7 students can be arranged in 7 factorial ways. If n objects are given, then n objects can be arranged n factorial ways. Similarly, 7 distinct objects are there, right? Because students are given, they are all distinct. So, you can arrange them in 7 factorial ways. But here, restriction for teachers only. No two teachers are together. Since no two teachers are together, we need to place teachers between the students. That is our condition that we studied in types of permutations, right? So, given condition is no two teachers are together, then only one possibility is you need to place the teachers between the students. Okay. Now, check the possibility for teachers. Here you can observe one place. Here 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 vacant, and here 1 vacant place 8. Okay. Here green color represent teachers. See how many possibilities are there? If you place teachers between the students, total number of possibility is equal to 8 places are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay. So, we need to arrange 4 teachers in 8 vacant places. Okay. That is, in 8 vacant places are there, you need to make arrangement for 4 teachers. Arrangement of 4 teachers in 8 vacant places, you can write it as 8B4. Okay. Now see, first arrangement is arrangement of students followed by arrangement of teachers. So, total number of ways is equal to first student arrangement 7 factorial ways into teachers arrangement is equal to 8P4. Okay, it's the answer for the given question. Find the permutations of the word Mississippi. In how many of these 4 S's are together, 4 S's are not together, begin with the miss and begin with the sip. Okay. It's a very important 5 marks question. See, first question is find the permutations of the word Mississippi. Okay. Consider the given word MISSISSIPPI. Okay. It's a given word. Count how many letters are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. N value is equal to 11. In this 11 letters, check the repetitions. M, there is no repetition. Then what about I? I is equal to, how many times I given? 1, 2, 3, 4 times I repeats. Then check for S. S is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, again S repeats 4 times. Then P, check for P. Here see, P repeats 2 times. Okay. Now solve the first question, number of permutations of the word Mississippi. Okay, total arrangement. Arrangement is equal to, what's the total arrangement of Mississippi? 11 factorial divided by repetitions, right? 4 factorial into 4 factorial into 2 factorial. Because I repeats 4 times, S repeats 4 times, P repeats 2 times. That's why 11 factorial, that is N factorial divided by repetition factorials. Okay. Now take the question one by one. First question is, see, 4 S's are together. Okay. How to solve this one? 4 S's are together. Treating 4 S as a single unit. In that case, total letters, total letters is equal to, see, from the 11 letters, you are subtracting 4 letters and treating it as a single unit. 11 minus 4 is there. Okay. It's equal to 7 letters are remaining. 7 letters plus 1. Why plus 1? Plus 1 is the single unit, that has 4 S. So, total letters will get 8. 8 letters can be arranged in 8 factorial ways. That we know, right? If n objects are given, then we can arrange that in n factorial ways. Similarly, 8 objects are there, we can arrange that in 8 factorial ways. But our observation is, in this 8 factorial arrangement, each arrangement has one single unit. And that single unit has 4 S. Okay. Then, single unit 4 S can be arranged in how many ways? Okay, see, 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 S's are given. See, total letters is equal to 4 factorial divided by repetition factorial. S repeats 4 times. 4 factorial by 4 factorial equal to only 1 time. We solved similar problems, right? If all the objects are identical, then there exists only one arrangement. Because see, if you write second S here, you will get S only. See, arrangement is same, right? Or take the last S in the first, then S. Can you see any difference? No, right? If objects are identical, then there exists only one arrangement. Single unit having 4 S can be arranged in only one way. Okay? So, total arrangement is equal to, what's the total arrangement possible for this one? 8 factorial ways, right? Because 8 factorial into 1, it's equal to 8 factorial only. Okay. Now see the second question. Second question is 4 S's are not together. 4 S are not together is equal to total arrangement minus number of arrangements when 4 S's are together, right? So total arrangement minus arrangements when 4 S are together. Okay. Now simplify this one. It's equal to, what's the total arrangement that we calculated in the first step itself, right? Total arrangement is equal to 11 factorial divided by 4 factorial into 4 factorial into 2 factorial minus, what's the arrangements when 4 S's are together, minus 8 factorial. Okay, so this is the solution for the second case. Take the third problem, that is begin with the miss. Okay, see 11 letters are there, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. It is a given word. Whatever arrangements you are doing, your word must start with miss. That is possible only when you need to fix MISS in the extreme left position. Okay. If you fix 4 letters, then see how many letters are remaining. Okay, 11 minus 4, only 7 letters are remaining, right? After fixing MISS in the beginning, that means in the extreme left position, then 7 letters are remaining. You need to make the arrangement for the remaining 7 letters. Okay. So, to solve this problem, fix MISS in the left. Okay. After fixing MISS in the left, number of letters is equal to 7, because out of 11, 4 letters are fixed. In these 7 letters, check the repetition. MISS is fixed. Okay. Then see, I repeats 3 times, S repeats 2 times, P repeats 2 times. Okay. Now see, number of arrangements is equal to n factorial, that is 7 factorial divided by 3 factorial into 2 factorial into 2 factorial. This is the solution for the given question. Begin with any letter given means first you need to fix that letter. After fixing, count the remaining letters. Take it as n. In that 7 letters only, find the repetitions. If you observe, you can see here, I repeats 3 times, S repeats 2 times, P repeats 2 times. So, total number of arrangement is equal to 7 factorial divided by 3 factorial into 2 factorial into 2 factorial. See the next question, begin with SIP. Okay. Again, same Mississippi you need to take. Here I will take 11 letters, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Okay, 11 letters are left. 11 letters are there. In these 11 letters, begin with the SIP means first vacant place S,
second vacant place AI, third vacant place P. Okay, these three letters are fixed. Now see, MI, SSI, SSI, double PI, Mississippi is given. So, in this one S is already used, one I is already used, one P is already used. Now count how many letters are remaining. Here you can see na, 8 letters are remaining, right? After fixing SIP, number of letters equal to how many letters are remaining? 8 letters are remaining. In this 8 letters, calculate the repetitions. M only one time is there. I is equal to, see, one time here, one time here, one time here. Okay, only 3 times. Actually, I 4 times. But here, see, one I is already fixed here, right? We are not doing any arrangement for SIP. Okay, we are doing arrangement for the remaining vacant places only. Here you can see. So, 4 I's are there, but 1 I is already fixed, so I repeats 3 times. Then go through S. S how many times there? S is equal to 1, 2, 3 times. Then P, okay, here see, there is no repetition of P, right? Actually, P repeats 2 times, but already 1 P is fixed, so only 1 P is remaining. There is no repetition of P. So total arrangements is equal to, what's the total arrangement? 8 factorial divided by 3 factorial into 3 factorial. Okay, n factorial by p factorial into q factorial, that is repetition factorials. Okay, total number of letters is equal to 8. In that 8 letters, I repeats 3 times, s repeats 3 times. So, number of arrangements possible is 8 factorial by 3 factorial into 3 factorial. Okay, this is the solution for the given question. In examination, they may ask it for 3 marks. That means they will ask any 3 cases. Here you can see 5 cases are given. But in the examination, 3 mark question, and they will ask any 3 cases. But this one is the very important question. See the next question. Find the numbers of permutation of the letter committee. What are the given questions? How many of them begin with T and end with T? Second question, how many of all the vowels are together? In how many no two vowels are together? How many of them end with the MITE? Okay. First, take the given word, that is committee. COMMITTEE. Okay, this is a given word. Okay, count how many letters are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 letters are there, right? These 9 letters, check the repetitions. C only one time is there, O only one time is there, but M, that repeats 2 times. Then I, okay, COMMITTEI only one time is there, but T 2 times and E also 2 times is there, okay. So M repeats 2 times, T repeats 2 times and E repeats 2 times, okay. Then see, first question is find the number of permutation of the given word itself, right? So total arrangement is equal to n factorial, that is 9 factorial divided by repetition factorials, 2 factorial into 2 factorial into 2 factorial, okay. Then see, take the first case. In how many of them begin with the T and end with the T? Actually, 9 letters given. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. You need to use the letters of the word committee. You need to fix T here in the extreme left position, and in the extreme right position again you need to fix T, because in that case only you will get begin with the T and end with the T. So here see, for this T only one arrangement, that is the extreme left position. For this T only one arrangement, that is extreme right position. Now see, in middle how many letters are remaining? You can see 7 letters are there, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 letters are there. So here I will write fixing T's in extreme left and right positions. Letters is equal to number of letters is equal to how many letters are remaining? 7 letters are remaining. So n value is equal to 7. Okay. Then see, in that 7 letters, how many times m repeats? M repeats 2 times. T, there is no repetition. Why there is no repetition? Because one T is fixed here, another T is fixed here. Okay. There is no arrangement available for T. But E repeats 2 times. Okay. So number of arrangements is equal to n factorial, that is 7 factorial divided by m factorial, that is 2 factorial into 2 factorial. This is the number of arrangements and begin with T and end with T is given. Okay. See the second question, ovals are together. Observe the committee, number of ovals is equal to, how many ovals are there? Number of ovals is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. E 2 times 1 I 1 O. So number of ovals is equal to 4. Ovals are together, that means you need to treat that 4 ovals as a single unit, right? So treating 4 ovals as a single unit. Okay, if you treat it as single unit, then number of letters is equal to, what's the number of letters? See, out of 9 letters, 4 you are treating as a single unit, so 5 letters are remaining. Plus 1, why plus 1? 1 is the single unit, so 5 plus 1 is equal to 6. Okay, now 6 letters are available. Okay, then what's the arrangement of 6 letters? 6 letters can be arranged in how many ways? 6 factorial ways, that we know, right? If n objects are given, we can arrange that in n factorial ways. Similarly, 6 objects can be arranged in 6 factorial ways. Okay, then see, each 6 factorial arrangement has one single unit. That single unit has 4 ovals. Okay, then single unit having ovals. What are the ovals here? O, I, double E. Okay. This single unit can be arranged in how many ways? How many objects are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 factorial divided by, why divided by? Here you can see, right? E repeats 2 times. So 4 factorial divided by 2 factorial ways. Clear? Actually, in the first step, you are treating 4 letters as a single unit, that is ovals. So remaining is equal to 5 plus 1 single unit is 6. That 6 letters can be arranged in 6 factorial ways. Then single unit, you need to make arrangement for the single unit. We know that single unit has 4 ovals, namely O, I, double E. You need to arrange single unit, that can be made by 4 factorial, n factorial numbers divided by repetition factorial, that is 2 factorial, because E repeats 2 times. Okay. Now see, total arrangement is equal to first arranging the 6 letters, that can be made by 6 factorial ways, into, that means followed by arrangement of single unit, that single unit can be arranged in 4 factorial by 2 factorial ways. So this is the answer for the second question.